Charlie boy.
Who's this?
Oh, that's Bruce.
Bruce. You know, they say food tastes different on the outside, Bruce. What'd you say?
Shit, I don't know. I try not to eat prison food on the outside.
Let's get the fuck out of here.
Hey, Tara.
Brad?
What are you, a produce manager now?
Well, whatever needs to get done around here, manager. Fruit ain't gonna stock itself.
Oh, I hear that. So, did you hear about Morgan's baby? We got a call, she wanted to deliver it home. Kids started coming out, but it was breached. We tried to turn it around. Yeah, she pushed it through, though, but the head got caught up, squished like an avocado. The baby's fine now, but it's got a big old dent. Kind of looks like the baby's got a little ashtray on its forehead.
Brad.
Well, why? You know, Morgan, I thought you'd want a double.
You sure you don't want a bigger one of those?
Eyes for angles here. Keeps parking the patrol car behind Sammy's. Catnap.
I told you I'm not napping, I'm meditating. Anyway, I was telling your daughter about Morgan's kid and how it looks like she's got a little baby ashtray on her face.
That's great.
Baby ashtray.
Perfect, Brad.
Right?
What?
Listen, Mother's cooking dinner this Thursday. It'd be nice to see you there.
Yep.
He's always welcome at the house. You know that.
Yeah, I know.
Honey, I just want you to be happy.
We're fine.
Hey.
Bye, Dad.
So, about one for the deputy. No? Okay.
Bye, officers. You're all late.
Yeah. Got caught up with Flynn's. So I don't need a lift again.
Marlene reading the riot act when you dropped him off?
I did not stick around to hear that.
Workouts for half price, so I bought extra. Don't flip on beer.
What did you say?
Man. Come on, I got dinner tonight. Pork chops are gonna be cold.
Yeah. I love cold pork chops.
You guys are pretty close with this Nick fella, huh?
What?
Three of us. We were gonna go down to Mexico. Buy us an orange grove. Sit around, drinking tequila. Fucking seen him, and it's one of the greasers picked him for us. know, Bruce, things work out, you might be able to come with.
Yeah. That'd be real special.
You know, not that it matters. I mean, a job's a job. But, what happened?
Well, you know what they say about plans?
Yeah.
Shit happens.
Forche?
Good to put a face to the boys.
Okay.
About that. The man you're looking for, he isn't the easiest fellow to find.
You get my address?
More or less. I got an address. But, thing is, with travel expenses, $2,000 is not gonna cut it.
We had a deal.
That was the deal. I'm gonna need another $2,000.
Another $2,000?
See, a man in prison pays you to find another man. $4,000, this feels right. I think I'm well within my bounds to renegotiate.
I don't got it.
Now, you look like a resourceful man. I'll wait.
That's $2,000. You take it. You give me that address.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm gonna cut you a deal, all right?
Ah! Oh, motherfucker!
You got a deal.
Fuck!
Give me the address.
Fucking Marlene, man.
What's that?
Tuna?
That's what that is. Yeah.
Yeah, every damn day, man. I ask for something different. What's she giving me? Tuna? It's like she's fucking with me, man. Like Mexican tuna, Japanese tuna, American tuna. I don't know.
Hey, Sal.
Yeah?
I got a shift open this weekend. Are you interested?
No, man. Can't do it. Working on Jordan's cabin again. We got rained out.
Right, right. Yeah, building Noah's Ark, right?
Mm-hmm.
Enjoy that hunting trip.
Oh, no. No, that's just work. I swear.
All right. Don't be coming next week begging for a shift because you got rained out. You understand me?
Yeah, boss. You take that shift if you want, man. I can work on the cabin myself. Make it 50-50.
No, man. 5 days a week in this place is enough for me. Besides, I'm gonna go hunt.
Hey, man, it reminds me John asked if he could come.
What'd you tell him? No, I told him to fuck off, man. There's not enough room in the truck.
Seriously?
Yeah, we go hunting. No, I don't want to deal with him.
You still buy your gun?
No.
Why not?
I owe money, man.
Copy.
Go ahead, Brad.
Hey, I'm taking off. Here at Sauce, I'll see you tomorrow.
Copy that. See you tomorrow.
Thank you.
you make sure Sal pays you back some when you get paid for this job.
I don't know. What?
You? Sometimes I think your mind's a million miles away.
You sure you're gonna be all right? You being gone on the weekend?
Yeah, I'll be fine. I promise. Marlene might come over later, maybe watch a movie. She gets someone to watch the kids.
You got, Jordan's number, right? You need to
get it. I've got it taken care of. I will be fine. Go, have fun. Something for the way up.
Thanks, baby.
Got no food?
Just wasn't in the cooler.
Well, if you get some time, bring it back full.
All right. I better go get Sal before Marlene locks him in the house.
All right. Let me. When you're working, you can't fix chairs if you're missing a finger.
I know, I'm gonna try not to poke an eye out even. Hey, if you look at me, you're gonna be super cool to your mom, right? That's right, you help her out whatever she needs. You know, you're perfect. Yeah, you are. Feed her this time.
Yeah, I'll make sure to do that.
Okay. All right, bye, love you. See you Sunday.
Make sure he stays out of trouble, Nick.
Will do.
Get the fuck out of here.
I don't know how you guys do it, man.
Hard liquor.
We all serve your kind here.
Oh, yeah, what's that? Smart, handsome men?
You got the men part, right?
Let's go, buddy.
How's my cabin coming?
I don't know. I guess we'll see it when we get up there.
How's it hanging, Sal?
South. As always, man. Just don't get up like you used to.
Yeah, I hear you. What are you ladies drinking?
Anything cold.
On the house.
You here? Appreciate it.
How's Tara doing?
She's doing all right. I'm busy.
How you doing?
I'm all right. You still got a phone back there?
Yeah, come on back. Tell Tara I said hello.
Will do. Just got to Jordan. We're about to head out to the cabin a little bit.
Not sure where you are, man.
Nick.
Yeah?
Hey, sorry. I was in the shower. I heard the machine cut on.
It's all right.
Yeah, we just made it out here a little bit ago. Just sent Jordan.
Having a couple.
Having a couple. Be careful in the dark.
Especially on those roads.
I will.
You eat dinner yet?
Yeah. Here's the quiche.
Oh,
Jordan says hi.
You come and sit her back.
Yeah, I will. What was that?
Oh, bacon pie. Okay. In case Marlene comes by. Speak of the devil.
I gotta go. Alright. Love you.
Yeah, I love you too. I'm coming. About a goddamn moment, Marlene.
Hey, man, she left you yet?
Tell her I said hello?
Yeah. She said hi back. You tell her I said hi? Hell no.
Hey, man, you'd think I wouldn't have to ask, you know? You just tell me.
This shit, man? That's a big motherfucker, man. Looks like it hurt. Get your ass gone.
Fell down.
Fuck you, man. Yeah. Hey, I'm serious, though, man.
I was just hanging out with the wrong guys for a while. You're sort of like a... Didn't add up to anything good, that's for sure.
The fuck kind of answer is that, man?
My dad and Jordan went back quite a ways, and he's the one that introduced me to Junior. I figured it was better to, start new somewhere where I knew a couple people. And I met Tara. That was it, that sealed the deal. You married right at that one, man. At least your father-in-law can get you out of tickets. Mine just kicks me in the teeth. Yeah, well, we got something in common on that one. Well, yeah. I got one too, you know? What's that?
Check that out. Look at that right there.
Oh, shit, where'd you pick that up?
Marlene.
Marlene?
That was her ex-husband. I mean, technically, it was her husband at the time.
Wait, so you broke up a marriage?
No, wait. Wasn't like that, man. She had one foot out the door already. I mean, she came in the upholstery store, asked to have the recliner done. She was just radiating that energy she has, man. I was done, man. Took one look at her. That was it. Of course, now I think about it, getting her pregnant before she was divorced probably sped some things up a little bit, but he didn't take too kindly to that. He came in and hit me in the head with a tire iron one day. Yeah, I was out for 20 minutes. Woke up about 15 stitches.
No shit.
I mean, I don't really remember much, but it's kind of fucked up, if you ask me. Marlene and I got married a few weeks later. And she's been around ever since.
What happened to the husband?
He went inside for about 4 months. Got married in prison, actually. So I don't feel too bad. Anyway. Just to find another one that'll fuck you rotten and cook you breakfast afterward.
She fucks you rotten, huh?
No, not really, man. One out of two ain't better.
Afternoon. How's it coming?
I'm gonna need another weekend at it, but it's coming along.
What you got there?
Popped a couple of those. I thought you might want to smoke some.
Oh, man. Speaking of my soul now.
Hey, can I use your phone again?
Yeah, of course.
At the road.
Yeah.
I just called your place. Nobody answered.
No? Nobody? She usually gives him a bath right about now. Who knows? Maybe she drowned him. Might have found a friend.
It is so good to see you, Nick. I got a question for you, though. You got any ice cream? I mean, initially, when we came in a little late, the missus was making a pie, and we got it back in the fridge. Doesn't that sound normal? Pie and ice cream? Yeah. You wouldn't have any butter pecan, would you? Nick? Go see if he's got any ice cream.
Seriously, I'm fucking bleeding out here. I gotta get this looked at.
What you think you were gonna do? You were gonna put on a mask and make believe you were normal? Hmm? I'm gonna catch up to you. You killed her the minute you put that ring on her little finger. It's kind of ironic, isn't it, Charlie?
That's what I call it, yeah. Nicholas, we're the only family you got. We're the only ones who will ever understand you for what you are.
We were a fucking family. And you tried to kill us.
That's pretty funny. I actually had better be kind.
Hey, Bruce. Shut up.
When we first showed up, man, we were here for, what, 2 days? We were here talking about the weather, all kinds of shit with a little lady with Tara. Tara is her name, right? Was her name.
Man, you should have seen her. She wouldn't shut the fuck up, man. She was asking us all kinds of questions. Real inquisitive. And then she told us about the money. Imagine that. She told us that you said that you inherited the money. Who the fuck is leaving you any money? Who does that to their wife? Who lies to their wife like that? What kind of man does that, Nick?
Did you use our money to buy this place, Nick?
Because that's what she told us. Shit. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter anymore. You should have just fucking come to me.
God damn it, bro!
Fucking listen up! Elijah. Nick. I guess this is what they call closure. Thank you. Stay away from my daughter. But she did. I told her not to marry you, but she did. I said I didn't know you like she did. I knew exactly what you were, didn't I? Now I'm sitting here wondering why I shouldn't take my gun. Just...
Who do you think did this?
Don't push me, Nick.
You gotta let me go. You think I'd do something like this?
I know you were hunting with Sal. The coroner told me. She'd been dead for 2 days. I know you didn't pull the trigger. But you know who did, don't you?
Yeah. And only knows if you let me go.
Well, that's not the way we do things around here, son. Where are you going? Can't be here right now. You let me know the second he wakes up.
Sure, all right.
I'll be back in a few. But for now, you just watch him like a fucking hawk.
Look at that. He's awake. How's your chest? Hurts, don't it?
I don't mind.
What?
Thirsty.
Jesus fucking Christ, man. Nick? Oh, what the fuck? Nick, what the fuck happened to you, man? Where you been?
They had me at the hospital.
In the hospital? Oh, man, I went there and cops said you weren't there, man. You all right?
Oh, shit, man, I'm so sorry.
I heard about Tara.
Here. You've been trying to say that you killed her, man, but I know that's bullshit, man. Hey, look at me, I know that's bullshit. You know, dude? Hang on, I need your help.
All right.
I need you to help me hide this car, and I need to borrow your van.
Yeah, anything you need, dude. Well, but I'm gonna go with you.
No, I can't let you do that, Sal. I can't let you get involved with this.
I'm already involved, dude. You're asking me to hide a police car in my yard.
No. Hey.
Look at you, man. I'm not adding you to this alone.
You want to stop talking about it and go do your thing?
I don't like this, Sal. I don't like this one bit.
Just remember what to say if they come asking.
I don't think you should do this.
You do the same thing for us, okay?
I'm really sorry, Nick.
Leave the light on for us.
Don't get yourself in trouble, Sal.
Sorry, Frank.
God damn it!
You get back over to his house. You arrest anybody who comes within 50 yards of that place. And you radio me right away if you do. You got that?
Yes, sir.
Place off 90?
Yeah.
Can I help you?
I'm looking for someone.
Someone?
Three men. They would have stayed here over the weekend, driving a green Cadillac. They would have paid in cash. Stayed in room 102.
Who'd you say you were?
Brad Ingalls. Sheriff's Department.
All right, let me check real fast. 102. Ford. Walter Ford. That's the name he gave me.
They still here?
They were here a few nights. They came and went a few times. They left this afternoon.
You were in that room yet?
Nope.
Let me in that room.
Yeah. 102.
What are we looking for, man? I don't know. Yeah, I think they're long gone. This is Parson.
Receive 911 call from the Highway Host Motel. Called to drop, but the line is still live.
10-4. On my way.
Called around 7.
He signed the band?
Lab said they want to be able to pull the prints for a couple weeks off the caddy.
What about the boys in Colton County?
Nothing.
That's a
using those.
That's fine. How you doing?
I'm doing.
Coffee's been on for about an hour. Sheriff's Department. Frank, you gotta call on line one. I think you might want to pick this up.
This is Frank. I'm on my way.
Oh! course you did.
Now look at me. You were supposed to die in that house, didn't you?
Couldn't see that.
Where is he?
We could have been a family again. Like before.
Okay. He's in the station. What station? Truck stop. It's just down on the road.
Come on, Nick.
Thing I had in this life.
take you in, Nick. Justice isn't yours to serve. This ain't the law, Nick. You should let the law handle it.
The law wouldn't do what I did.
The law's the only thing that keeps us from being savages.
Like I said, I can't go to prison, so you do whatever you gotta do.
Tell people I served this town for 30 years. That my blood is in this dirt. And in all that time, I only ever did one bad thing. If you even want to call it that. Maybe that's entitlement. Maybe not. Whatever it is, though, it's a choice I can live with. Imagine if they let Saxon go instead of shackling him to the temple. It'd have been a different outcome altogether. Imagine that.
Thank you. Thank you.